Oke, kita sekarang ada di talk show Citra Web Solusi Teknologi dan bersama saya hadir Ilfat, ya, Ilfat Head of Sales Indonesia Teltonika.
Yep. Ya.
Jadi kita sekarang punya suatu produk yang kita jual juga Teltonika dan dalam beberapa seri video setelah ini kita akan berdiskusi. We will discuss about Teltonika equipment.
Yep.
Ya. Why we should use this? What it's for, I think it will be very interesting to know.
Yep.
So, Ilfat, one of the series in Teltonika product is RUT or root.
Yeah. RUT, yeah.
Yeah. What is this about?
So, in a simple way, basically, RUT, it's a router.
Yeah.
But it's not just router, like usually we have in our home or mm-hmm. something like that. It's industrial router. So, if we will took the router in our hands, we can see that it's aluminum case.
Okay, so that's the difference, yeah, between industrial
grade,
and regular router.
Yep. Basically, if we will talk about the functionality, mm-hmm. it's like many benefits. Mm-hmm. But the basic things, what's different between industrial and consumer device, yeah. it's more protocols, so we can use to connect to many device. It's like an IoT device.
Okay.
It's a smart device. So we can, if in simple way, yeah, mm-hmm. Router can discuss to call to end device,
to
any end device.
Make communication. Other device, yeah.
Yes, and get data from the end device.
Okay.
Send to server. Mm-hmm. And etc. And mainly, what routers we have in this table? It's a cellular device.
Okay.
So Teltonika like focusing in a gateway market. Mm-hmm. So in a case if you have if you need backup internet.
Okay.
First of all, for example, you have a cable internet, you mm-hmm. have fiber optic, anything, and if you need to have a protection to have connectivity always, like if it's very important connectivity, like banks, mm-hmm. hospitals,
yeah.
Servers.
Yeah.
So you always can get access with this device. So it's a cellular device.
So maybe if we have like the fiber optic or Ethernet mm-hmm. link,
yep.
it's broke, we yep. still can connect it to
yes.
this device and yes. also the end device
yep.
using the LTE.
Yes, and this router also can provide the cable connection. So we have a RJ45 mm-hmm. or Ethernet port. And it can be automatically switched to the SIM card. If, for okay. example, we lose connection by cable, mm-hmm. we automatically switching to the SIM card.
Okay.
Or make SIM card as a main connectivity. For example, if it is remote area,
yeah.
so mainly Teltonika yeah. in Indonesia using in remote area, mm-hmm. where we don't have access for cables or something, so we're using SIM card for connectivity.
Okay. You talk that this device is industrial standard.
Yep.
What is the standard of the industrial?
So first of all, it's a temperature range.
Okay.
Because for temperature, consumer device, usually it's plastic one, mm-hmm. and usually components inside cannot survive.
Okay.
Because Indonesia is hot country, or if you're talking about the cold country, it's also important.
Yeah.
So our temperature range is minus 45 and plus 75.
Minus 45 to?
Plus 75.
Plus 75, okay.
But let me explain why 75.
Yeah.
Basically, our router, I have experience. Mm-hmm. I'm not promising in our technical documentation mm-hmm. it's 75.
Yeah.
But I have experience when our equipment was installed in a box, and in the box was 80 plus. Okay. 90 plus and okay. sometimes even 100 plus.
So even if the weather is only 35, 40,
yeah.
inside the box can be much higher. Yeah?
Of course it will be higher because their equipment that's
yeah.
working.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, if temperature is too high, mm-hmm. Why we put 75? Because usually with a plus 75 SIM card broken first.
Okay.
So. Probably, if you have a temperature range in your box more than 75 and mm-hmm. you lose connectivity, probably it's SIM card broken and you need to use industrial SIM card. That's already another topic. Mm-hmm. If we're talking about the equipment surviving.
Okay.
We have a experience just share. We have a case when we install 500 routers in gates in the roads yeah. for monitor traffic, speed limit, everything. And in the box there was 100.
So it's on the traffic pole.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, in the traffic, it's like a gate.
Yeah.
Like if we imagine like a toll road that I'm using from Jakarta to Georgia. Yeah. There's have some gates that monitoring temperature, the road, is it wet or not, camera, speed limit of cars, and many data should be sent to the server. And in this case, I have experience when we achieve plus 100. And from 500 routers, in 3 months testing, just only one time, two routers was reboot.
Okay,
so it means can survive.
500, it's only very few routers reboot.
Two routers from 500.
Okay.
And just reboot, so it's not broken, it just was reboot. And yeah, it's about if you're talking about the industry. Also, if you're talking about some vibration, it's also can survive. So we have installed in oil companies, and etc.
It's So it's not only about the case,
Not
only about that this is an aluminium case.
Yep.
But also the component you choose to be inside this product.
Yep.
So, okay.
And usually, if your devices in your site have a problem, have issues with the connectivity or sometimes rebooting or some problems, probably you just need to switch to industrial grade and then it will be survived.
Okay. And how about the power in, powering this device? Is it needs a very specific voltage or ampere?
Basically, I'm not expert in this case, but I will answer in simple way.
Okay.
It's also our benefit because our device can work with a very low power.
Okay.
I'm not sure about the range, but if I'm not mistaken, if I'm not wrong, it's from 9 watts and up to 35, 40, something like that.
Okay.
And we also have a power protection.
Okay.
So power protection, if your electricity have a jumping, sometimes it's not stable.
Yeah.
Our device can survive also as well. I also have an interesting story from one engineer. He was the, I don't know, can I say about it or not? So if something you will can.
Yeah.
He was a fan, he was have his own laboratory. He make meteo stations in the road.
Yeah.
And he was test Teltonika with the power. So he trying to play with the power. He trying to burn our router. And his laboratory test, he was test a few devices. I don't want to say the brands.
Yeah.
And one of them was Teltonika. So Teltonika showed the best result and this partner decided to use Teltonika.
Okay, so because, it can survive the spike of the voltage.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. So if we talk about the remote installation, I think most people will use a solar panel, very low electricity.
Yep.
So this device also can work well with that?
Can work well, but need test.
Okay. So what is the topology or sample where people install this device?
Exactly, RUT200.
No, the RUT.
Any
era RUT.
Okay, so in a simple way, RUT200 is like our basic device. Here have two Ethernet ports. So in a simple way, we can connect to anything that have RJ45.
Okay.
And can get access to any end device. If it is even a router, if it is PC, industrial PC, mini PC, camera. So we can get access, can upload data, receive data, download, update configuration, and make it remotely. So let's say it is PC, it's my router, I'm sitting in Jakarta, you are in Georgia, device is in Georgia, and I can make remote monitoring for every device. And we can get access for 1,000 routers, and if I want to update some configuration or something, then I just making it in one click. So this is the benefit because you can get access for everything. If we're talking about the use cases, the like most popular use cases, I would like to talk about RUT956. It's our bestseller in the world.
Yeah.
So we have 19 offices in the world, and this is a device from where we started. So here we have a RS232, 485 and IO, and four Ethernet ports. Also we have a two SIM card and GPS. Everything in one router. And it was best solution in Teltonika Networks. It was first use case. And when we use RT956, it was connectivity for bus, public transportation.
Public transportation. What you used it for the public transportation?
For public transportation, here we can connect payment terminal, counting passengers, panic button, video cameras, and everything to one
GPS
device, and GPS as well. So it's like a combined solution for everything. Mm-hmm. And this is our bestseller. We have many projects in many countries, like in all continents in the world. It's like a bestseller. And also, especially in Indonesia, we can connect whatever you want with this industrial interface. Mm-hmm. So if your end device have interface, let's say RS-485 or RS-232, mm-hmm. so we can get access, remote access, and control and monitoring. If we need simplify the connectivity, so for example, you have only one port and you need to connect, let's say, smart meter.
Smart meter, okay, yeah.
RS-485. And let's say in your house you have 20 smart meters, you can connect through one RS-485 mm-hmm. and can get data from all the smart meters through one device, through one port, because it's like, in details, it's called full duplex.
Yeah.
And we calling to each smart meter and getting data through this port. And if need only this port, we also have a gateways. Mm-hmm. It's another topic we will discuss later. So there only one gateway, one SIM card, one port.
Okay.
But if your solution, if your use case need many ports, so 956 it's the best option. Also, if we're talking about RT200, it's like I said, it's a basic device, but it's still smart device, so it can be connected to our remote management system.
Yeah, RMS,
yeah. And here only one SIM card, two Ethernet ports, simple, but and small size, the also important thing. So
the for serial, I think this model will work. Yeah.
Yeah. If you need serial ports, yes, you're just using 956.
And this is also I/O for the IoT device, IoT sensors. Yeah.
Yep. So we have a digital and
analog.
Analog, yeah.
Okay. And I see here we have two slot of SIM cards.
Yep.
Can you explain what it's for?
Basically, two slots. It's for backup connectivity.
Okay.
So for example, here have a one modem in simple language. One modem talking with one SIM card.
Cellular, yeah.
One cellular, connectivity. If, let's say, Telkomsel, this is the main operator for router. So we can setting everything. Mm-hmm. So we can say to router, like, this is the main. Let's say Telkomsel. And something happened in a basic station in Telkomsel. Mm-hmm. We lose connectivity or router is moving and don't have a connection to Telkomsel. Here have another SIM card slot. Mm-hmm. And there will be automatically switching to the another SIM card.
Okay, so it's a failover. Yeah,
failover. And also we have a device, it's X series, where we have not one modem that connecting and switching, but two modems and making connectivity parallel. So two SIM card, two modem, both of them working.
Okay.
And getting connectivity from two SIM cards.
Okay. So, in what industry usually people use this device?
Basically, I work in networks, and I would like to answer to your question like that, everywhere.
Okay.
So, everywhere should be connectivity. We're living in 21st century. Mm-hmm. All cities now starting to be smart city.
Yeah.
So, smart city, retail, energy, utilities, anything. Where we need to get some data, when we can save the time, we can save the people power, don't need to go to repair something, we can do everything remotely.
Yeah.
So basically our routers can be used everywhere.
Okay. Usually some industry asking for a specific certification.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What certification did this equipment has?
So, if we're talking about certification, Teltonika investing a lot of money and power for certification. So we usually providing all certification that needed for each region. So if we're talking about Indonesia, it's Postel.
Yeah.
So it all equipment of Teltonika have Postel already here.
Okay.
So it's certified devices, and we can use it like free. Everything registered in a Telkom Cell and Indosat, so all providers, and it can be worked. Also, we have some specific certificates for some industries. If you want to see all of them, you can find in our website. It's quite easy. So, the, for example, the last one, what we did for our one device only, one router, RTX 11, they have a EN certificate. It's for trains.
Oh, for trains, okay.
Yeah.
And also for oil and gas, because in Indonesia we have a lot of oil and gas industry, right? Is there any specific certification for?
Better to check.
Okay.
Yeah, better to check in our website. They have all certification, and you can find exactly what you need.
So Irfan, in some industry, they need security for their network. Do you think that these models also can support the security they need?
It's exactly for that basically.
Yeah.
Because our routers using by army, police, banks in many countries. Why? Because we have a lot of options for VPNs, firewalls, and even the simple thing, for example, if you start connecting to your router, you need to, they have a default
username, password.
Yeah, username and password. And Teltonika pushing the user to change the password after first connection.
Okay.
It's already like a security. And also our device, not only security, like main benefits. I also would like to mention it's easy to use because any engineer that have a experience with settings with some routers, some network equipment, easy can handle with our router because it's based on our operation system. We call it RootOS.
Okay.
And it's based by OpenWRT, WRT.
Yeah.
So it means you can change everything by yourself.
So even we can change the OS,
based on
open
based on open WRT so it's a really friendly interface for any engineer, any level of engineer. And the last thing is reliable. It's not my words, it's words from my partners, from my experience, that if you don't want to have a problems, if you don't want to have issues with the equipment, if you just want to install and forget.
Install and forget,
Install and forget. It's about Teltonika. This is the main benefit. Of course, everybody's saying like that.
Yes.
But here already just about the trust. Okay. Trust, try, and we'll be happy.
Okay, thank you, Irfan.
Yeah.
So we already discussed about the root models of Teltonika, reliable, security, and easy to use.
Easy to use.
Okay. Yep. Sampai jumpa di video-video selanjutnya tentang Teltonika products.